Oh, hello everybody, and welcome once again to today's Sunday sermon, which is on the 19th Sunday of the year. You notice that weeks are mounting up. But today, God is speaking to us in a special way about the word disappointment. Disappointment means sadness or displeasure caused by non-fulfillment of one's hopes or expectations. Today in our readings, we have two very disappointed people. In fact, three. St. Paul in the second reading, which I'll deal with later. But in the first reading, Elijah. Elijah has come out of his own land and has run away. He has hidden in a cave where God told him to hide, and he met God in a gentle breeze. And God said to him, "What's wrong? Why are you so downhearted, Elijah?" "Look," he says, "your people that I'm trying to be a prophet for have disappointed you. They have broken their agreement with you and destroyed the altars and killed your prophets with swords. I am the only prophet left, and now they are trying to kill me too." Then in the gospel, Jesus walks on water to rescue the disciples who are having trouble in the lake from a big wind that blew up. They're being tossed about. He walks on water and he says, "Do not be afraid." And Peter says, "If it's you, let me come out of the boat and walk on the water as well." And of course, Peter, being impetuous as he is, he walks on the water for a while, and then he loses his faith, his heart, and he begins to sink, and Jesus rescues him. And Jesus is disappointed. He says, "Oh, you of little faith, why do you doubt?" So today, we are looking at that word disappointment. Now, we need to be aware that we too can disappoint others. We can disappoint others by our maybe lack of appreciation, to say thanks maybe. We can disappoint others when we don't remember them. They're there living alone, maybe in the COVID virus situation, and nobody phones. You won't pass on the virus by phoning a person, and so forth. So we know what disappointment is. Nearly all of us looking and listening to this today will know what I'm talking about. All of us have experienced disappointment in one way or another. Sometimes we create our own headaches though, when we expect too much. And the most purest motivation for doing anything good is to do it and don't expect anything in return.
Disappointment is a terrible thing. You will end up really disappointed if you think people will do for you as you do for them. Not everyone has the same heart as you. But sometimes we disappoint ourselves as well, when we don't do the right thing, or we forget to say or do the right thing. "Why did I forget that?" Or we just lost our composure and got annoyed with someone. Emotions took over, etc., etc., and we feel disappointed. But we should really forgive ourselves. Don't do anything so as to get back something for your own benefit. When you do things that are good for others, let it not depend on they appreciating what you have done for them. That would be an impure motivation anyway, and you will be disappointed. Do good and expect nothing in return. Then you might ask, why do it? Well, the seeds may have been planted somewhere, and that goodness will be fruitful one day. You may never live to see its fruits, but never mind, and leave it to God. Warren Buffett said, "Someone's sitting in the shade today because someone planted a tree a long time ago." Sometimes maybe we disappoint others. We need to appreciate and act accordingly to the goodness that has been done to us. Somebody may have done a very kind act, and then we have forgotten to take up the phone and ring them and thank them. How many of us have disappointed our parents in one way or another? Have we apologized to them when we have brought grief to them? And I am talking to all of us. We all have something whereby we have disappointed our parents. And maybe we have disappointed them when we never said thanks to them for all of what they did for us. Maybe we are all guilty of being ungrateful if we really think about it. We have to be careful. We are ungrateful to God when we sin, when we gossip, when we indulge in something unsavory. That is the foundation of sin, ungratefulness. Please try not to disappoint God as the Jews did in the second reading today. St. Paul has great sorrow and constant anguish in his heart, for the Jews in Rome have rejected the free gift handed to them. The dearest thing in all Paul's life was the fact that nothing could separate him from the love of God in Jesus Christ. But if it would do anything to save his brethren, he would even accept banishment from God. This is a huge statement. To help us to receive something from this message, the message of disappointment, we can turn it on its head and let's make God happy and satisfied and gratified by our approach. When we can say, "How do I think I satisfied or gratified God today?" We also speak personally to God through the following examples. "I prayed to you, my Father, in the morning before going to work, and I kept up the contact right through the day. I remembered you now and again and a lot of times during the day. I find that I am even doing it more often than I used and bringing you into my life. I saw you in others when I respected them. Even if they upset me in any way, I respected them as your creation, your gift to me. I trusted you right through the day, especially when I had that accident maybe, or confrontation with somebody, or a disagreement. I felt you beside me. I listened and saw you in nature, especially that sunset, that breeze, even the rain. The seasonal manifestations like leaves falling or fruit coming to life and trees. I saw you in the man begging or just walking aimlessly on the streets, and I wondered, what is his story and how can I help him? When I looked at TV, I saw you bobbing up and down on the high seas, desperately seeking security in the hope of a new beginning in the life of my sisters and brothers who are refugees. I prayed for my brother or sister dying alone with the COVID-19 virus. I visited you in my neighbor in the hospital and saw you in him. I gave encouragement to my friends who confided in me who have marriage or relationship problems or even financial problems. Finally, I knelt down, or at least I sat, and gave you the very last greeting as I went to bed. The end of a near perfect day.
Good dog. These are my two dogs, Hagrid. I think it's a figure from the Harry Potter series. And the other one is Lulu. She was a great singer in England one time. Got into the Eurovision. So there you are. It's a simple and childlike trust in God, such as the prayer above suggests. By doing that prayer and in that simple way, we will never disappoint God if we try. And God knows a trier. He loves a trier, and he knows when we are sincerely trying. Let us always be on the side of generosity. Don't expect much. You won't be disappointed. But in another way, expect great things from God. God knows that we fail, and he always allows us to come back. But God will never fail us, and he will always be there. Once we make that little effort, he will always be there to encourage us on in our simple relationship with him and with others. May God bless you and help you to have a lovely Sunday, and that this message may mean a lot to you. Also, the coming week, remember, do things for God for the right motivation, and know that God sees and takes note and is always encouraging us. That is the God we believe in. Have a lovely time. Come. Hagrid. How are you? Lulu. Lulu, come. Come, Lulu.